What makes a person a hero? Let me introduce you to one of my historical heroes. Sam Houston, 1793 to 1863, was an American politician best known for his role in bringing Texas into the United States as a state. His victory at San Jacinto secured the independence of Texas from Mexico. Sam Houston was an individual who stood behind his personal convictions and principles for what he believed was the best for Texas, regardless of the popular opinion of the day. Even though these principles were not conducive to his political career, he refused to back down to an overwhelming majority. For his insistence that Texas not leave the Union, which he loved so dearly, Sam Houston gave up the governorship of Texas. My name is Shelby Lepley. I'm fortunate to be a member of the Texas 4-H, and I also live in Huntsville, Texas, home of Sam Houston. There are many individuals I consider heroes. Sam Houston is one of them. There are some very specific reasons this individual is a hero to me. Sam Houston valued education highly. He was steadfast in his principles and persevered even to the point of personal loss. Sam Houston was an advocate. I feel strongly that we should strive to be advocates just like Sam Houston. Let me tell you why. Sam Houston was the only American to be elected governor of two different states. He was also the only Southern governor to oppose secession leading up to the American Civil War. He refused to sign the Oath of Allegiance to the Confederacy, which ultimately led to his removal from office.
In the name of the Constitution of Texas, which has been trampled upon, I refuse to take this oath. I love Texas too well to bring civil strife and bloodshed upon it.
In his passionate speech for the support of the Compromise of 1850, based off the premise of Matthew 12:25, Houston said, "A nation divided against itself cannot stand." 8 years later, Abraham Lincoln would express the same sentiment. I personally appreciate and recognize the commitment, the dedication, the motivation, and the passion for this most driven man. He truly had all the characteristics for his unending advocacy for Texas. True leaders who advocate for their cause place their head into their dedications, their heart into their commitments, their hands into their actions, and their health into their passion. More than enthusiasm or excitement, passion is ambition materialized into action. This is when you place as much of your head, heart, hands, and health into something as much as possible. As a dedicated 4-H member, I can appreciate these traits. My personal goals include striving to take my ability for advocacy through 4-H to a higher level as well. There are two defining features of a true leader: dedication and passion. Dedication and passion are not traits found in people who are merely motivated. They're not even found in those people who are enthusiastic or excited. Add commitment and an unending concentration to your dedication and desire, and you too can be a true advocate. Passion is when you put more energy into something than is required. Materialize your energy and ambition into action, and you too can be a true advocate.
I am aware that in presenting myself as an advocate of the Indians and their rights, I stand very much alone.
We must have advocates who stand up for what they believe supports the very foundation of our communities, our country, and our world. We need heroes to help show us the way into the future. I choose to advocate for agriculture, education, freedom, and my 4-H. I invite you to join me and make the best better and be an advocate also. How dedicated was Sam Houston's advocacy for Texas? His final words to his wife, Margaret, were, "Texas, Texas, Margaret."